Good morning. My name's Dr. Jeremy McAnulty from New South Wales Health. I'm here to provide an update of the COVID update for 4th of October in New South Wales. This is a live update. Until 8 o'clock last night, in the 24 hours, we had 623 locally acquired cases reported in New South Wales, and there were 76,892 COVID tests reported in the same period. Across New South Wales, we now have 88.4% of people aged 16 and over who've had their first dose of COVID vaccine, and 67.1% who are fully vaccinated. And the total number of vaccines administered in New South Wales is now 10.3 million. So thanks very much for everyone for coming forward for vaccination. We need to continue to get those vaccination rates up to protect yourself and the community. So thank you very much. Just an update on hospitalisations. There are currently 959 people who are admitted to New South Wales hospitals with COVID, including 193 in intensive care and 97 of whom require ventilation. Sadly, we're reporting the deaths of 6 people who've been diagnosed with COVID, 3 men and 3 women. One person was in their 40s, 3 people were in their 60s, one person in their 70s and one person in their 90s. 3 people who died were from southwestern Sydney, 2 were from western Sydney, and 1 person was from the Nepean Blue Mountains. 4 people were not vaccinated. 1 person had received 1 dose of COVID vaccine, and 1 person had received 2 doses of COVID vaccine. The person who had received 2 doses of COVID vaccine was a woman in her 90s who died at Hawkesbury Living Nursing Home and acquired her infection as part of an outbreak there. This is the 4th death linked to that outbreak. A man in his 60s from southwestern Sydney who died at Campbelltown Hospital also acquired an infection at the hospital. This is the 3rd death linked to this outbreak, and we'd like to extend our deepest sympathy to the family, friends and loved ones of the people who have died. There have now been 378 deaths in people with COVID in New South Wales since the 16th of June 2021, and 434 in total since the start of the pandemic. I'd like to call out now the suburbs and towns with the highest numbers of COVID in the last 24 hours. These are Liverpool, Wellington near Dubbo, Doonside, Plumpton, Bankstown, Granville, Wollongong, Blacktown, Fairfield and Carrabar near Queanbeyan. But no matter where you live in New South Wales, it's important to come forward for testing, no matter how slight your symptoms, so that we can identify if you have COVID and help protect your family and friends. Now, this long weekend, it's been a particularly big for the fans of NRL, and we hope everyone enjoyed the game, but we need to make sure that we're all protecting our communities and through these times where we've got still quite large numbers of COVID in the community. So social gatherings are not permitted in homes, and the number of fully vaccinated adults who can gather outdoors remains at 5. So please take care of each other. Please follow the rules to help protect us all. I want to give you an update of regional cases reported in the 24 hours to 8 o'clock last night. In Illawarra, there were 77 new cases reported in the Illawarra-Shoalhaven area. In the Central Coast, 32 new cases. In southern New South Wales, 21 new cases. In the Hunter, New England, 59 new cases. In western New South Wales, there were 23 new cases. In northern New South Wales, 4. In the Murrumbidgee, 1 new case. In the far west, 1 new case. On the mid-north coast, 3 new cases. And in the southern Highlands, 2 cases reported from the Whinjacarabee Shire. Thanks very much, everyone, for coming forward to vaccination, for remaining vigilant for symptoms and getting tested if you have any symptoms, and for obeying and following those COVID safety rules, which are there to keep us all safe. Thanks again.